Imagine you've again succeeded to sneak into a party where you're not invited, and you're discussing with people you've never met before. At some point, someone talks to you about Linda. She's 31 years old, single, outspoken, and very bright. You also learn that Linda majored in philosophy, and as a student, she was deeply concerned with issues of discrimination and social justice and participated in anti-nuclear demonstrations. However, two people are arguing about one point. One of them thinks that Linda has now become a bank teller, but the other one says that besides being a bank teller, she is also active in the feminist movement. What would you think more probable? That Linda is a bank teller? Or that she is a bank teller and active in the feminist movement? You've probably answered the second option, as the 90% of people question. But surprisingly, it turns out that this is not the mathematically correct answer. To understand why, imagine that this circle represents people who are bank tellers in the world. This other circle represents people who are active in the feminist movement. The two circles could overlap. Some people will indeed be both bank tellers and active in the feminist movement. Now visually, it is very clear that this area in the middle is smaller than this whole blue area. What that means is that the number of feminist bank tellers will always be smaller than the number of bank tellers in general. That includes feminist bank tellers, but also all sorts of bank tellers with interests in other domains. Your math teacher would say that the probability of two events occurring together is always less than or equal to the probability of either one occurring alone. This is why it's incorrect to assume it's more probable that Linda is a bank teller and active in the feminist movement. It is disputed what to conclude from this experiment. Are people bad at maths? Is it really a reasoning mistake? Or is it just that the word probable can mean multiple things? The mathematical concept, or a less strict meaning of plausible? It's indeed the case that in real-life situation, it's often useful to assume that what your interlocutor says is relevant somehow. So if you learn details about Linda before you're asked a question, you can reasonably assume that those details must be relevant to answer the question. No matter how you interpret this experiment, the fact is that this bias exists and could play tricks on you in real-life situations if you're not careful. And in case you still don't believe us on what is the correct answer, try to consider now that 100 persons fit the above description of Linda. Would there be more bank tellers? Or more people active in the feminist movement and bank tellers? Now the effect should disappear, and you should intuitively get the correct answer. Don't forget you can follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you soon!